Okay, good afternoon students. Till now we have covered about the coaxial cables, that is part of microwave passive devices. So we'll see the types, different types of I hope last class we have seen this the different type of like coaxial connectors and adapters, attenuators and phase shifters, waveguide tees and magic tees. We'll be covering all these things. So basically in the last class we covered about this construction part, the coaxial cable. Basically, to understand the coaxial connector and adapters, we should be knowing how the coaxial cable is. And so this is the construction of a coaxial cable. We are seen the demo also. So basically the coaxial cable are used to connect the cables to other devices and are specially designed to maintain the shielding onto the cable. And male connectors have a protruding metal pin in the center, and whereas the female connector have a receptacle to receive that pin. So a coaxial RF connector, radio frequency connector, is an electrical connector designed to work at radio frequencies in multi megahertz range. And the RF connectors are typically used with coaxial cables and are designed to maintain the shielding that the coaxial design offers. Better modules also minimize the change in the transmission line impedance at the connection in order to reduce the signal reflection and power loss. Yeah, because this is very important. Signal loss and the power loss is very important thing in the transmission line. So we have to see that the better models, actually the more sophisticated modules, the models of the coaxial cable, they tend to reduce the basically the reflections from the your impedance mismatch or any kind of load imbalancing. So there will be a kind of power loss. So as the frequency increases, the transmission line effects become more important, with small impedance variations from connectors causing the signal to reflect rather than the pass through. An RF connection must not allow external signals into the circuit through electromagnetic interference and capacitive pickup. Now this is very important aspect, because this coaxial cable which is there, so they are actually very, very less prone to such kind of interferences, because the optical fiber has, it has got very much, you know, high, you know, immunity. So, but whereas coaxial cables have got certain interferences which may happen, but not as much as the other cables which are there, like twisted pair cables or the copper cables. So this coaxial connectors have got so much of shielding is there. Covers are there. So we have seen the I'll just switch over to the note mode also. So why these coaxial cables are not very prone to this kind of interferences? Now this coaxial cable, as you know, this has got, we have already discussed in the last class, the coaxial, like if you take the, cut open the coaxial cable, this is the, like say, this is the coaxial cable you have. And if you cut open the coaxial cable, first of all, there is a inner sheet, like a thick shield which is there. If I cut open that, so this portion which is what is there is the in outer sheet covering the plastic or polyvinyl chloride. So this is there, and inside if you see there is another layer which has got your perforation, so metal stripes. Then again there is a one more layer. So the last layer is your insulation layer, and then finally we have the core. The core is the one, if you say different layers, like one we have the outer covering here, this is your outer covering. Okay, this is your outer covering. So once you have the outer covering here, now this outer covering, this is the plastic which actually simplifies your any kind of losses or any kind of interference from the outside. Now apart from this, there is one another perforation what we have seen. So after this you are this thing, there is one more that is metal surface is there, like there is a layered like this metal. If you see this in the like if I cut open that portion, it will be like in the part like this. You can see in that, you have seen this metal like this in the perforation, it is there. So this the wire meshing which is there, this mesh will cause it will filter the whole whatever is happening inside. No, so any which is external noise or external radio frequencies or any kind of waves which are there floating outside will not enter here because of this mesh. So if you want to see that mesh, there is one which I have got this. See, can you see this mesh? So this portion is there, metal. So this is the metal which I have like, you know, which I can do like this. So this is the outer covering, this is, and this is the metal which actually stops the interference, external interference, any kind of radio signals which are trying to interfere. This will stop the interference, noise will not go. So once it is there, then finally we have another another plastic cover. See here, you can see another plastic insulation is there. This is the insulation, another one. So then finally we have the copper core. This is the copper core. So there are four things. One is your plastic cover, then is metal metal, this is the metal you know, strap, or which can be, it's a mesh kind of thing. And then we have this is the plastic insulation again insulating between the core, copper core positive and this negative metal. So this actually also a lot of the work that is done. So when we talk about this thing, so when you see here, this portion, so this portion is your plastic outer covering. So this is your mesh, that is your mesh, that is wire mesh which is there. And then you have one kind of coating called as another plastic coating here. So I'll put a plastic coating by this yellow. So yellow coating is there. So once you have this yellow coating, that means there are two things here. One is, this is the one layer. So this is the second layer. There are two coatings actually. So this is the one coating which is there. If we cut open the section, then finally we have, this is the core, copper core, what I can call. So this is the copper core, which is actually your conducting medium. So this is your conducting, this is all along your copper coaxial cable, which is there. So so many layers are there if you cut open the your coaxial cable. Now the signals are passing through this pink line, that is your copper wire, whatever is there. So this this is a positive part of your you know, this is your positive core, becomes your positive, and this part becomes the metal portion, that is a mesh kind of thing, is becomes the negative. And this is your insulation material, insulator, a kind of a plastic. And then another insulator we have, this is the one outer covering, what we call, this is also a plastic. Now we can call it as outer cover, though this also can be called as insulator, but it is not insulating anything, it is outer covering, but made up of same material. So since it is insulating between your positive and negative, that's why we call it as an insulator material. Now here it is covering the whole thing, so we call it as a covering. So this coaxial cable plays a very important role in kind of your transmission lines. Now, can you tell me why this coaxial cable is used here? Why use the waveguide? What happens if I use a waveguide for a TV signal? We discussed in the last class. Yeah. Saurabh, but I hope my connection is intact. Saurav, are you there? Yeah. Okay, you are there. So, what are the difference between coaxial cable and your waveguide? Basically, when I can use both. I can use both transmission lines. These are the transmission lines only. But in case of a coaxial cable, whenever I am using where there is a less power is involved. Now, when we talk about a high power, so we use waveguides. High power with high frequencies. So now, in case of generally what we do in case of a coaxial cable, anything less than 3 gigahertz, we go for a kind of coaxial cables. But the moment it goes above 3 gigahertz of the frequency, then we go for this kind of waveguides. So these are the very important things you should know, because there may be a question like asking what is the difference between coaxial cable and waveguide, when can we use coaxial cable, when can I use a waveguide, all that things that there may be a question. And so basically these coaxial cables are used where a kind of like reflex klystrons. Wherever I am using reflex klystrons, when I am using reflex klystron, so these are actually microwave transmitters. Actually, these are all microwave transmitters. Now there are we have already discussed when we talk about the microwave klystrons, they are all low power. These are all low power based microwave amplifiers. They can be used as oscillator and also can be used as amplifier. But whereas if I take same thing, microwave amplifier, that is your magnetron. When I use magnetron here, this is your high power, this is your high power. This is your high power. This is also a transmitter. I can use it as a, this also as a transmitter, or I can use it as a receiver, a local oscillator and all. Here also I can use this one as a transmitter. Basically, this is used for high power, is used for transmitter in the radar section. So these are some things which you need to calculate. There may be a case where you can use coaxial cables, like for TV and all, we use the coaxial cables. But now, if you generalized applications, if you see, we can use here, like in the fourth, this coaxial cable can be used for TV, setup box. Nowadays, we all deal with setup boxes and all. But in case of this kind of this thing, we use in case of a microwave oven. So this microwave oven has got a magnetron followed by a waveguide. So these waveguides are used in the microwave setup. So these things you should be aware of. So there are four differences. So you can always quote in the exam if it comes in the exam. Okay. So the RF connectors must allow extended signals into the circuit through electromagnetic interference and capacitive pickup. So they should not have an interference. So this will not allow any external signals going into the circuit, because whenever you are connecting, that's why the setup box is also like, see, you must have seen the setup box is there. The coaxial connectors are connected to the setup box to the TV from the antenna. Now, suddenly, if there is any kind of external, like say, there may be a transformer just adjacent to you, or maybe kind of a signal which is there, some kind of mobile signal. Even if you keep a mobile near to the coaxial cable, which is like the like I want to show you. This is very important. You can do this experiment today in your home. When you go to home, if you see, concentrate here. It's a very important experiment you can do. You know, you have in your house. Okay, this is your house, and there is a TV in your house. Okay, this is a flat TV which is there, LED TV, and you have a setup box. You have a setup box which is just placed below or near to the TV, and you have connected a cable which is going and this is getting connected to TV here, and other end is of the setup box is connected to the your dish TV. So this is your dish TV antenna which is there. So this dish TV you are connected, so this cable comes from here somewhere and it gets into your setup box. Now this is your TV setup box I'm talking about. This is your TV, okay, LED TV. See, this is your, whatever you are connecting here is your coaxial cable. So this is coming into your this thing as a coaxial cable. Now you can do a testing where you put a micro, your mobile phone here. You put a mobile phone near to this coaxial cable and switch on the TV and see, because this is an interference. This is a mobile, is a transmitter. Radiation, it actually emits the radiation. So if you please keep this and try it out, what happens to TV? Actually, as per this thing, if there is any interference within this cable, then your TV signals should be disturbed. So please check this. What will happen to the TV? Is there any noise or is there any kind of interference in that? So kindly, you have to do, you can do this experiment. So these coaxial cables are very immune to such kind of interference from the outside. But when the frequency increases, and the power handling capability increases, that means when the frequency increases, high frequency with high power, then what happens? You will have interference. Then these coaxial cables are not suitable for such condition. So when the frequency increases, when the power requirements are high, when we talk about the high power requirements, then these coaxial cables may not be suitable for this kind of setup. So definitely when we have this kind of situation, we have to go for a waveguide. So that's why in TV we use coaxial cable. That's why we don't use the waveguide here. We could have used the waveguide, but what happens is here the power handling capacity is very, very low. Low power capacity, the setup box. So that's why we do not use the waveguide here. But whereas in the microwave oven, so same setup, when we talk about the microwave oven, in the same setup, in the microwave oven, if you cut open the microwave oven, what are all components it has got? It has got a magnetron, which is a transmitter, RF transmitter, which transmits electromagnetic waves of high power, more than some 1 kilowatt of power at least. So this can generate more than 1 kilowatt of power, RF. Now I hear, now your microwave oven is there. So here there is an opening, the waveguide is connected here, and there is a waveguide opening is there. It is connected to this portion. This is your waveguide. Sorry, my diagram is not that good. Try to draw a good diagram. Yeah, this waveguide is there. Now when there is an opening here, the waveguide outlet. So this is the waveguide outlet which is there. So what happens is, this is the termination. This is the terminator, or you have a attenuator, fixed terminator. So this is your microwave oven, okay. The full box is there. So when you have box here, now these waves, whatever waves which are generated here, so this will be, like I'm enclosing this in a box like this. Okay, this is your microwave. My figure diagram is not very good here, so I will redraw this correctly. Yeah, this is your microwave oven. So when we have this kind of setup here, microwave oven, now this chamber where you keep the food, so there is a round glass case which is there, which rotates like this. So this, where, you know, this electromagnetic waves comes out of this waveguide and the signals will be available everywhere, the microwave signals. And sometimes these waveguides are placed in such a way that they are from the side also it can generate. So from side also there is a waveguide outlet. Sometimes the wave will come out of this portion also, and this portion it will go and terminate, something like that happens. So all these waveguides, so this is the waveguide, this is your waveguide. So we cannot use coaxial cables here in the microwave. Why we can't use coaxial cable, Mahima? Here Mahima, are you there?
Yes sir.
Why can't we use coaxial cable here as a transmission line? Because our power requirement is high, because we are expecting power somewhere more than 1 kilowatt of power. So whenever there is a high power requirements is there, that time I cannot use coaxial cable. So only for low power requirements I can use coaxial. But the moment the power goes high, so my waveguide will come into action. Okay.
Okay, sir.
This we are talking about the microwave. Okay. I hope students are busy with recruitment or something like that. Okay, fine. So mechanically, RF connectors may provide a fastening mechanism, that is thread, bayonet, braces, blind mate, and springs for a low ohmic electrical contact while sparing the gold surface, thus allowing very high mating cycles and reducing the insertion force. The research activity in the area of radio frequency circuit design has surged in the 2000s in the direct response to the enormous market demand for inexpensive and high data rate wireless transceivers. And also the common types of RF connectors are used for television receivers, two-way radio, certain Wi-Fi devices with removable antenna, and industrial and scientific measurements using RF frequencies. So these are the several connectors which we can see, different type of coaxial connectors which are there. These are the coaxial connectors and adapters, like stecker and all different type of connectors you can see. So now we talk about the adapters. Till now we talk about the we spoke about coaxial cable and their connectors. Now we talk about the adapters. Now adapters are RF adapters are passive coaxial components that are used to transfer signal from one connector interface to other. They can be used to transition signal from an SMA connector interface to an N-type connector interface of BNC. So one type of connector to other type of connectors, these are the adapters are used. You all know we use adapters for transferring from three-way to two-way, two-way to three-way. Like that we use here also, one connector to another connector, we use these adapters. The geometry and the gender of each connector interface can vary and be customized to meet the required of a user. Now this is one type of connectors we can see here. Like here, what I want to do is, you can understand, I will just again go out. So I'll use here. We talk about adapters, right? Adapters. Now these are the microwave adapters. These are the passive devices which are there. So in this adapters, what happens is you have a kind of like you have a box. Now you want to connect a coaxial cable at one end. You want to connect a coaxial cable here. So this is your coaxial connector. So you connect one coaxial cable here, which is coming from outside or wherever. Now this coaxial cable you are connected here. Now other end you want the waveguide, like you want to take a waveguide output. So your waveguide you want here. So your waveguide is connected here. So this kind of setup, what is there, is your, like this is the waveguide, rectangular waveguide we are talking about. So when you connect one end and other end to some other of this thing, so this is your can use adapter. Now you, this is adapter what we use. So this is your waveguide, and this is your coaxial cable. This is your coaxial cable, and this is your waveguide. So when you want to use both, or like sir, some signals are which are coming from outside in the coaxial cable. Now I want to convert it into a waveguide. So this is your waveguide structure which is there. So what I do, I put a kind of adapter in between. So this will be your adapter. So this is the adapter portion which is there. So I'll connect an adapter here for converting from one signal to other signal, that is interface. This is the difference interface, coaxial interface. This is your waveguide interface. Is it clear, everyone? Mahima?
Yes, sir.
Is it clear, adapters? Harshita? Nandana? Gagan Navina? Gagana Navin, are you there? Pooja?
Yes, sir.
Understood the adapters? Gajula Pawani?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now you can see this here. Now here, one end you can see here. This end is a waveguide. You can see the waveguide opening, the rectangular portion waveguide which can be connected here. And here you can take the coaxial output from here. So this is the adapter which is used to connect a coaxial cable. From coaxial cable, I will connect it to a waveguide. So this is a very important aspect which you have to remember. So this connector is called as an adapter. So similarly, we have another type of this is the coaxial connector, and this is your waveguide output, waveguide, rectangular waveguide. So some terminologies regarding this, like this is the your cable, coaxial cable core, and this is your insulation, and then we have an outer mesh, and then the final insulation. So the coaxial cross section, if you take, the core diameter means the coaxial cable core diameter means D. This is the diameter of the core, that is copper wire which is there. So if you compare with that, there is an ampere law for this coaxial cable. You can see it is given by integration of B into DL, so which is your mu naught I enclosure. So this is your you can see here the these are the different versions here at the center when you take how the current is flowing and how the various parameters are shown here. You can see here the coaxial paper. This is the concern to your ampere law. Then we have the how the voltage and current distribution takes place in a coaxial cable. So this is how the this is the core of the coaxial cable. So we can have at the one end, we can have say that it is a 50 ohms because it is a impedance, the 50 ohms on the both the end. And in the central line, we can have an II, and we can have a one current flowing this side. And in the Skinner, that is the IS inner core, which we have here, which is flowing in the opposite direction, because there is a metal surface also in between. And then in the, finally, we have another outer, that is IS, which is flowing in this direction. So totally, we have a kind of, if you see the coaxial cable, it has got a capacitance and a supply, and there is an IG also. There is another current which is there, and this is the V out. That is a 50 ohms across 50 ohms. It is there V out which you have taken. So this is the diagram. You can draw a coaxial cable with currents and voltage terminations. So this is your actual coaxial cable. This is your coaxial cable, and these are the connectors. Okay. and then we come to attenuators. What is an attenuator? What attenuation is your opposite of the amplification. So attenuator is an electrical device that reduces the power of a signal without appreciably distorting its waveform. So basically it reduces the power of the signal without disturbing the actual waveform. And an attenuator is effectively the opposite of an amplifier, though the two work by different methods. While an amplifier provides gain, while an attenuator provides loss or gain less than one. So if anything gain less than one is the attenuation. So these are the some of the attenuators which are shown here, the some of the attenuators which can be used in your microwave devices to attenuate the signal. A passive attenuator is a special type of electrical or electronic bidirectional circuit made up of entirely resistive elements. An attenuator is a two-port resistive network designed to weaken or to attenuate the power being supplied by the source to a level that is suitable for the connected load. Now, sometimes your loads are they may not take the full power of the signal whatever being generated. So your load is not in a capable to just to take the load. So what happens is that time you need to use attenuators for reducing the signal power. So that it can suit your load requirements. So that's where we use the attenuators as a attenuation. So in the microwave signal system, we had a microwave system where we had an klystron amplifier generating the signal on the waveguide channel. In between, we had an attenuator also, so that to suppress the signal if the need arises. Now we have a phase shifters. Phase shifters are a critical component in many RF and microwave systems. A phase shift module is a microwave network module which provides a controllable phase shift of the RF signal and are used in phased arrays. These phase shifters are used to change the transmission angle of the two-port network. Like you can see this figure here. Now one end I am receiving signal here, this one. Now I want to change the phase of the signal. If it is coming, incoming signal is in the horizontal portion. Here I will take out the output in a vertical position. So there is a change in the phase shift. So there the phase shift happens because of the phase shifters. Are there any questions in this? Fortunate people have joined till now. Okay. Any doubt till now? So what is the phase shifter? Joshna? Joshna, are you there? Gajula Bhavani? Okay, we'll see some question papers. We have a long way to go. We'll be solving certain question papers also in between. Now, what kind of questions are being asked for this portion? This is antenna and propagation. So this question paper is not valid. Now, this is your. Yeah, microwave and antenna. Now there is a question like this. Explain coaxial line fixed alternator with a diagram. See, this should have been a fixed attenuator, but by mistake they have put alternator. So sometimes such question, if it comes, then you will get 5 marks without doing anything. You just have to attempt this question, that's all. Just write something about this, then you'll get 5 marks. Because this is a wrong question. The question should have been, explain coaxial line fixed attenuator with a diagram. So a line with an attenuator. So you have to draw a line with a attenuator which is placed. So basically, what happens if you see in terms of this? Okay, your coaxial line which is there. So okay, I will take it down. The coaxial line which is there, one coaxial line. Now in between coaxial cable you put an attenuator. And signal is taken output from the attenuator. So this is your attenuator, and this is your coaxial cable. So what happens to the output? Output power is reduced here. So if you have assume that you have an output of input, you have around 100 kilowatts of power. Like we talk about the coaxial cable, so we talk about 100 watts only. You cannot go in kilowatts. So you say 100 watts of power signal is sent to through a coaxial cable. Now if I put an attenuator in between, so this will attenuate the signal. So when it attenuates the signal, your output will become approximately 60 watts. So this is the line, your coaxial cable with a attenuator. So you have to show what happens if you use this thing. So this is a kind of a coaxial cable. With fixed attenuator. When you have a coaxial cable with fixed attenuator, then this kind of output will reduce. You can see the output from 100 watts, the output is going down to 60 watts. So now this depends on how much output you want. Depends on the attenuator. So there is a setting here. So on the attenuator, you can say you can take output like 50 watts or 20 watts. It can be reduced to 40 watts also. So 40 watts, 20 watts, depending on type of attenuators you are using. It may be 80 watts also. So whatever your requirement says that there is an adjustable tuning is here. So the knob, if you rotate the knob as per your output, like if you set to 80 watts, you will get 80 watt output power. So if you set at 60 watts, then you will receive only 60 watt. Like that, you can have a, you can change varied, But here we are talking about the fixed attenuator. So that's why when we talk about the fixed attenuator means, if it is the question comes coaxial cable with the variable attenuator, then this will hold good. If the question comes, it is a fixed attenuator, then only fixed to certain predetermined wattage, that is 60 watts, whatever we have. So your output will remain only 60 watts, irrespective of anything you do. That means this is the fixed attenuator, what we're talking about. Okay. So when we have a variable attenuator, then it has got different positions to vary the output power. So this is your one setup like this. You have any questions in this? I'm just saving this PDF in case if you require in your future. I'm just saving it. Okay, any questions anyone wants to ask regarding the today's class? No doubt? These are your adapters. This construction of the coaxial cable, voltage and current relations with respect to coaxial cable. Cable connectors and attenuators. These are the attenuators you can connect in between the coaxial cables. And these are the phase shifters. Okay, so with this, I have concluded my class. So you have any questions, you can ask now. Mahima, have any questions?
No, not, sir.
Yeah, no questions. Okay, Divakar Reddy. Meghana Kini. Meghana, are you there?
No, sir.
No, you are there.
Yeah.
No question. Right. Okay, yes. Yeah. Okay. Joshna, are you there? I think Joshna is not. Joshna is busy. Yeah, you are there. Who else? Amrita B.R.? Understood? No questions?
Sir.
No questions? Your voice is not very clear.
Sir.
Okay. Uday Prakash?
No doubt, sir.
Understood, na?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Lohit?
Yes, sir.
No doubt?
No, sir.
Pawan Kalyan?
Yes, sir.
No doubt, understood the concept?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Ritu Andrea?
Yes, sir.
Have you understood?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Sanjay GM? Sanjay GM, are you there? Sneha P.
Yes, sir.
Sanjay. Sneha P.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yashika. Yashika. Okay. Fine. So I'll be picking up the attendance now. Wait. Approximately 49 students are there today. Yeah, I'm saving the attendance. Wait. I hope you have understood all the this thing. So we are having now, next is the phase shifters. We'll do some numericals. And also we'll see waveguide T and magic T's. Then we'll try to solve some numericals related to that. Okay, I have picked up the attendance. If you have any questions, you can discuss. We have got another 4 minutes to go. Anything you want to ask? Mohana, any doubt?
No, sir.
No doubt. Okay. Shall we close the this thing? If we do not have doubt, then I'll stop the recording.